Welcome to this brief guide on how to organize tabs in Google Sheets. Are you tired of endlessly scrolling through your tabs in your Google Sheets, struggling to find the information you need? Do you wish there was a way to organize and group your sheets for better efficiency and clarity? Well, you're in luck. In this tutorial, we'll explore various techniques to effectively group tabs in Google Sheets, making your spreadsheet experience a breeze. Let's start at the beginning. Here we are in Google Sheets, and my workbook has many tabs. One of the simplest ways to group these tabs is by using color coding. This will help you visually group related tabs and quickly identify them. Here's how. Move your cursor to the tab you want to color code and right-click on it. A menu will pop up with various options. From the menu options, select Change Color. This will open a palette of colors that you can choose from. Think about the content of the sheets that you wish to group. For example, you might use green for all of your financial sheets, blue for all of your marketing reports, and yellow for your project management sheets. Simply select a color that makes sense to you for each group. Then repeat the process for all the tabs you want to include inside these groups, applying the same color to each of them. Now take a look at your sheet tabs. You'll see clear visual groups, making it easier to find the information you need at a glance. Another effective method is to use prefixes in your tab names. This helps you in logically grouping related sheets. This way, even if the tabs aren't sitting next to each other, their names will clearly indicate their group affiliation. Just like we did with color coding, right-click on the tab that you wish to rename. But this time, choose the Rename option from the menu. At the beginning of the tab name, type a short prefix that represents the group it belongs to. For example, you might use FIN- for any finance-related sheets, MKT- for marketing sheets, and PROJ- for project management sheets. Repeat the process for all of the tabs in the same groups, ensuring that they all have the same prefix. Now, even if your tabs are scattered, their names clearly indicate which group they belong to, making it even easier to navigate and understand your spreadsheet's structure. Now that we've covered the basics, let's take our organization to the next level. What happens when we have so many tabs that these last options that we've spoken about aren't enough? We can look to create a clickable table of contents within your Google Sheet. This will act as a central hub for navigating your entire spreadsheet. Start by clicking the plus button at the bottom left of your Google Sheet to add a new sheet. Double-click on the Sheet tab and rename it to Table of Contents, or something similar that clearly identifies the purpose of this sheet. In the first column of your Table of Contents, make a list of the names of all of the sheets in your spreadsheet. In the second column, we'll create clickable links to each of these sheets in just a few steps. Here's how. Go to the sheet that you want to link to and click on its tab. Now, look at your address bar in your browser and copy the entire URL. Go back to your table of contents, and in the cell next to the sheet name, type in equals hyperlink followed by an open brackets and a quotation mark. Then paste in the entire URL that you just copied. Then close out the formula by typing another quotation mark followed by a comma, and then enter sheet name inside quotation marks followed by a closed bracket. Just replace sheet name with the name you wish to see as your hyperlink. For this example, we will just use the name of the sheet as it appears on the tab. Press enter, and you'll see the URL turn into a clickable link. Continue creating hyperlinks for all of the sheets in your spreadsheet. Now you'll have a convenient table of contents where you can simply click on a sheet name and then jump directly to that sheet. And for those times where you have a large project with several unrelated groups of sheets, it may be worth considering separating them into different Google Sheets files. The benefit of the techniques that we have covered today is that you can still maintain navigation between these files using the very same hyperlink function. Simply copy the URL of the other Google Sheet and create a link in your main sheet or table of contents. To do this, navigate to and open the separate Google Sheet file that you want to link to. Just like before, we copy the entire URL from the address bar. Return to the Google Sheet where we want to create the link. This could be your main project file or even your table of contents. Choose a cell where you want to place the link. Type in equals hyperlink, open bracket and quotation mark, just like before, and then paste in the URL that you just copied. Type in a second quotation mark, comma, and then the link text inside quotation marks and a closed bracket to complete the formula. Replace the link text with a descriptive name for the link, like the name of the other Google Sheets file. Press enter and the URL will become a clickable link. Now you can easily jump between different Google Sheets files with just a click, keeping your projects organized and manageable. Congratulations! You've now learned how to effectively group tabs in Google Sheets using various techniques. By implementing these methods, you can improve your organization, boost your efficiency, and say goodbye to tab chaos. Remember, the key is to find the approach that best suits your workflow and preferences. So go ahead and experiment, explore, conquer your spreadsheets with confidence, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.